Welcome back to our channel, everyone. I'm Bri.
And I'm Suz.
And we're Bri and Suz Cruz.
Today, we want to share a little bit about our Coco Cay Beach Club experience with you, specifically the lunch that they offer as part of the entry into the beach club for the day.
So let's talk about the food. With 5 starter offering, 8 entrees, and 5 desserts.
Well, I would challenge that it's really only 4 dessert offerings.
Okay, Suz, I know that you have some strong opinions about one dessert that you tasted, but let's take it all in order.
Okay, then let's jump into the starters.
Unless you object to it or you have an allergy that you've told your waiter about, they are going to bring you all 5 of the appetizers to kick off the meal.
Hummus, baba ganoush, tzatziki, ceviche, and shrimp cocktail. And they serve it family style from these 2 kind of cool bento box type containers. And your waiter will explain each of the offerings as they present the dishes. So let's talk about each of the appetizers just a little bit. First, there's the hummus. So I'm a big hummus fan. Brian is too. And this was a pretty standard version of hummus. Good, but not the best I've ever eaten. In my book, it needed a little bit more garlic, although you could taste the garlic in it. But in full transparency, I'm one of those people that think if a recipe calls for 1 clove of garlic, that really means 8 cloves.
Yep.
And in this house, we eat garlic like we live near a village of vampires and our lives depend upon it. So if you are not like us, then you're probably going to love the level of garlic in this.
Yeah, we're definitely big garlic fans. I'd say even if they didn't add more garlic, since some people don't love garlic as much as we do, this hummus also needed a little more tahini, honestly, and it tasted like they forgot the tahini completely. That nutty flavor could have added a bit more depth to the flavor of this hummus. Let's talk about the baba ganoush. Suz, you usually don't like baba at all, but you ventured out in tasting this one. What did you think?
Well, surprisingly, the baba was my favorite part of this appetizer plate. I usually, as you said, don't like baba ganoush. And it's really, I think, because it's far too smoky for me and almost tastes burned. But this had a beautiful, light, smoky flavor to it. And our waiter, Safrani Soren from Romania.
Hi, Soren.
he was awesome, by the way. He shared with us that the cooking method for the eggplant makes a big difference in how baba ganoush tastes. And he said if you roast it in a closed lid container, that it traps the smoke in and makes it much more intense. But if you do it over an open fire or an open air method, it makes it a lighter smoke flavor and lets the eggplant really shine. So I am all in for however they made this baba ganoush, because again, I don't usually like it, and this was a really good baba ganoush. It made me think of it basically being an eggplant hummus. It was really tasty. So if you don't usually like baba, I would encourage you to try this one.
Next up, we had the tzatziki. It was a very good tzatziki, nice and thick, so it stays on whatever you pick it up with. Sue says it rivals the tzatziki that I make at home. As you can see, there was crudité and pita to go along with the 3 dips. The one thing we would say is that the tzatziki could have had a little more cucumber for our taste. And we were a little surprised by the dill in it, but have since learned that many people do put dill in theirs. Now let's talk ceviche. This is another one Sue's tried, though she is not usually a fan. It was a Peruvian-style ceviche.
Oh, it was okay for me, but not something I'd order on my own.
It was okay as far as ceviches go. The spices were really good, but I found it a bit too vinegary, in my opinion, and it overpowered the fish.
Well, it must not have been that bad, Brian. You ate all of it both times we went to the beach club.
You're right. I probably am being a little critical, but people should definitely try it. And by the way, don't be put off by the jalapeno in the ingredients list if you are not into spicy food. It wasn't overpoweringly spicy. Now let's talk shrimp. You ate most of them. What do you think?
Okay, I'm guilty. I do love shrimp, and I ended up eating most of them while you ate the ceviche. They were definitely, well, they were essentially the same shrimp cocktail you get on the ship in the main dining room. They weren't too fishy. The cocktail sauce has a nice kick to it. So while they were good, don't expect that you're going to get something different or more elevated at the beach club than what they serve in the main dining room. Again, yeah. They're good, right?
Sorry. Yeah, I would agree. We found that with a few items on the menu. But there are a couple of items on the menu that really steal the show. So let's move on to the main event, the entrees.
Yes. So tell the folks what you ordered.
I ordered a few things both times we visited the beach club, but the main thing being the lobster, of course. The grilled Bahamian lobster. Now, this is something completely different than what you get on the ship. And this item tends to be one of the main attractions and draw for many people choosing the beach club. I was pretty excited when I pulled out the first claw. The lobster was cooked really nicely. It was firm but not overcooked, and it had a light and bright flavor to it. Even you, who normally doesn't like lobster, thought it was tasty.
I did. And speaking of tasty, it's served with truffle fries. What did you think of those?
Well, far too often, when something is truffle flavored or uses truffled oil, the flavor is just too heavy and the truffle is overpowering. So we were hesitant even to have the fries,
yeah,
which were included on the plate, but I'm glad we had them. The truffle flavor was not overpowering, and the fries were pretty good. They were crispy on the outside and fluffy on the inside, just how I think a French fry should be.
You mentioned that you ordered a few things, so tell our friends at home what else you got and what you thought of it.
The other entree that I ordered was the garlic tiger prawns. These were either somewhat small prawns or large shrimp. Hard to tell when their shells were. They were flavorful and similar to what we got at Giovanni's table. The flavor profile was definitely more Mediterranean, as it was with the apps. I think what disappointed me with these is that I was hoping for it to be prepared in a more Caribbean flavor profile to match the locale.
Yeah, I thought that about most of the menu, actually. A beach club in the Caribbean should probably have more Carib flair to the flavors of the foods. But, you know, they may be trying to go for something else. Something that did have the flavor profile I was looking for was the coconut lobster. On the menu, it's listed as coconut lobster sandwich. You can see it in that green band on the menu. And it's lobster with crispy fried coconut crust on it. I didn't really need or want the bun, so I just ordered it sans bun. But they still served it with the yummy rum-soaked salsa and avocado relish. Insert that's basically guacamole, with it on the side. So I didn't miss out on the flavor profile. I will tell you, friends, that the first time I had it, I loved it, even though I am not a fan of lobster, but I really, really loved it. The second time, however, I was not impressed at all. This one, you know, the first one was super tender, light lobster. The lobster was easy to cut and chew. Unfortunately, the second time, this lobster was tough and had a lot of connected tissue or sinewy pieces in it that just really made it unenjoyable to eat.
You also got the herb marinated fillet and the first time and the grilled Caribbean grouper the second time. What did you think of those dishes?
Well, the filet, as you know, was pretty darn good. It was the same cut of steak that you would get in Chops or Giovanni's Table, but the flavor profile and preparation style was definitely different. This was reminiscent of what you would get in the Samba Grill, kind of. It seemed to be either grilled or at least crusted, a bit crusted if they did use a flat top. But I do believe it was grilled. It was a little less tender than we usually get in Chops or Giovanni's, a little harder to cut through. However, the flavor was really good. It came with a chimichurri sauce, which I usually really like, but this version just didn't hit home for me. It didn't seem to have any spice to it, and the flavor was very heavy in the oil and oregano notes, and so it just wasn't very appealing to me. It didn't feel balanced. The Caribbean grouper had a really nice flavor. It's a light fish, and it wasn't a fishy flavored fish, which I know that sounds weird, right? But you know what? I think those who like fish and are picky about fish probably know exactly what I'm talking about. It was a nice firm fish, so it eats almost like a fish steak, not falling apart or flaking a lot when you cut it with your fork. And I really liked that about it. It was slightly too oily for me. You can even see the sheen of the oil in the photo, but not so much that I couldn't eat it and enjoy it.
We had some good food at these meals, and for the first time, we almost didn't even order dessert because we were pretty full. But Suze ordered the chocolate chip cookie, and I ordered the mango sorbet. My mango sorbet was good, but it was warm, so it melted quickly. Great mango flavor, but maybe a tad too sweet. I thought it was a little syrupy because it melted. I ate every bit of it, so clearly I did like it.
Yeah, what I didn't like, right? So this is the other thing that I'm like, it basically my chocolate chip cookie was a cookie from the Windjammer. I took a bite to see if maybe it looked like a cookie from the Windjammer but tasted different, but alas, no. So one bite and I was like done,
Well,
right?
Soren touted it as the homemade cookie. Well,
Yeah, come on, Soren. Don't tell people that because I was expecting so much better. But Soren did also redeem himself a little bit. He brought us the brownie, and it was so rich that we each could actually only eat one bite that first day. That said, the following week we did order the brownie ourselves, and between the two of us, we ate the whole thing. So it's definitely a quite decadent and delicious.
the second week, we also ordered the rum cake. When it arrived, it looked a bit on the dry side, but it was actually really moist.
It really was. And I'm, folks, I know I keep telling you things I'm not a fan of. I'm really not that picky of an eater, I swear. But I'm not always a fan of rum cake because it's usually so boozy and so overly sweet. This cake, however, was really good and it was a nice end to the meal. It wasn't overly sweet at all. And as a matter of fact, I would say it almost leaned more toward the savory side, but it served with a garnish of strawberry puree that really sweetens it up in a kind of a natural way. And the booze was there. Don't get me wrong, the booze was there, but it wasn't overpowering. So I really appreciated that. What do you think?
Well, it's not like those rum cakes that you get at the Tortuga factory or whatever that is, that, comes in a little box and you open it up and you can smell the booze and,
Yeah.
it's like overpowering. It was a little bit more savory.
Yeah. But I will say, like, don't let the description on the menu fool you or turn you off from it because they call it the rum-soaked cake. But I will tell you, it wasn't soaked and it was quite tasty. So I recommend you try it. So, Bri, overall, what did you think of this meal?
I thought it was fantastic. We kind of pick apart some things, but overall, the food is really, really tasty. It's served in a great manner.
And by great people, right? Like,
Right.
just like on the ship. I mean, Soren, we talked with him a little bit, and he's so fantastic. But he lives on the island, and is not on the ship. But I tell you what, the service level is just as good on island as it is on ship. He was fantastic. He was attentive. So you're going to get a great experience in your dining there on the island. You're going to get taken really great care of, and the food is good. Like you said, we kind of pick it apart a little bit because we have to be a little bit, judgmental of it just because we don't want to tell you it's great and then you find out it's not
I
great.
mean, surely, except for the cookie, everything else was great.
Yeah, it really was. It was good stuff. So we highly recommend that you have lunch there if at all possible. Check out the prices. Keep watching for price reductions. Some people have gotten the beach club as low as $58 per person. I haven't seen it that low myself, but we got it for $94 per person. And while I wouldn't pay that for just this meal, the full experience with this meal included was definitely worth that.
Right.
So
Absolutely.
thanks for watching. Please make sure that you like the video or don't like if you didn't like this, but at least interact with us and let us know what you thought of the video.
Yes, and also comment
Yeah, leave comments
and
below.
subscribe if you haven't.
Yes, subscribe and hit that bell so that you get notifications when we do post new information, new videos. But definitely leave comments below. Ask us questions. We are happy to interact with you and provide you information. You can also join us on our Facebook page with the same name, Bri and Suz
And
Cruise.
don't forget Instagram.
And don't forget Instagram. So we are very responsive on all of those platforms, and we would love to interact with you. Have a fantastic day, folks, and we'll talk to you soon.
Until then, I'm Bri,
And I'm Suze.
and we're Brian Sue's Cruise.